not mean? Well, it does not mean that we are to be lawless. Now, what are we talking about here? We'll have to explain this one. Notice the statement from Paul in Galatians chapter 6, verse 2. Bear ye one another's burdens and so fulfill, what does he call it here? The law of Christ. What does this mean? Are believers now under a new law called the law of Christ? The answer is no. God did not establish a new law for the age of grace and place believers under that law so that he'd have a new way to measure man's righteous performance for the purpose of permitting a heavenly entrance. That's not what it's about. Christ came not, as he stated in Matthew 15:24, but unto whom? Unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Christ's earthly life and ministry was directed solely at the nation Israel, the people to whom God had given the law of Moses. Even though he was the God-man and Israel's promised Messiah, never forget that Jesus Christ, during his earthly ministry, was a Jew under law, teaching Jews who were also under that law contract. Keep in mind that during the entirety of Christ's earthly ministry, the law of Moses was still in effect, and it was the manner in which God was dealing with his earthly people. Watch now as Christ gives to Israel, those under law, a new commandment. We see it in two places in the book of John. Here it is in John 13:34. A new commandment I give unto you. To who? To Israel. That ye love one another as I have loved you, that ye also love one another. Here it is again in John 15:12. This is my commandment, that ye love one another as I have loved you. Christ is speaking to the 11 here, folks, and he's telling this, he's relaying this truth, after Judas had left the upper room when he gave this new commandment to his disciples. This is one of the two commandments that Christ gave while ministering to Israel on earth. Both are contained in Christ's words in the book of Matthew, where we read in chapter 22, verse 37, Jesus said unto them, Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. The second is sitting in the second rendering of this, sitting in the next verse, verse 39. The second is like unto it, unto the first, Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments, watch it here, on these two commandments hang what? All the law and the prophets. So when Paul told the Galatians in Galatians 6:2, the saints in Galatia there who had been reverting back in their minds to thinking that God was dealing with them according to a law contract, when he told those folks, you're not under law, but you're under grace, what does he say to these very same folks? Bear ye one another's burdens and so fulfill the law of Christ? That's what he said. He wasn't telling them that God was initiating a new grace age law by which man could obtain righteousness before God through performance. If, as Christ said, on these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets, and if, as the Apostle Paul tells us, by the deeds of the law shall no flesh be justified in God's sight, then we need to understand, folks, that we're no more successful in this dispensation at loving God with every fiber of our being and loving our neighbors as we love ourselves than Israel was successful at law-keeping while the law program was in effect. Yet the Apostle Paul calls on us to love one another. Watch how Paul relates love to the law. He does so in Romans 13:8. Owe no man anything but to love one another. For he that loveth another, notice it, hath fulfilled the law. We're definitely not going to fulfill the law of Moses through our expression of love for others, if by the deeds of the law no man shall be justified in God's sight. But Paul tells us that we owe it to others to love them. Nonetheless, in light of how God loves us and how his son died for us, bearing the penalty of our sins as an expression of his love for us, we can certainly view all who God loved and Christ died for in that new light. And this renewed thinking can certainly lead to a new way of relating when it comes to our relationships with other folks. Paul knew that his position in Christ was not based upon his performance according to the law of Moses. Paul also knew, pardon me, that his position in Christ was not based upon his success at loving others. But that did not mean that Paul was lawless. Notice his words here in 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 21. To them that are without law, as without law, being not without law to God, but under the law to Christ, that I might gain them that are without law. Even when dealing with people who were not under the law, obviously a reference to the Gentiles here, Paul exercised himself according to what Paul called the law of Christ, preferring others above self. So again, not being under the law of Moses but under grace does not mean that we are lawless in the way that we're told to deal with one another. We can thank God that our position with him is based solely upon our union with his son and not upon our success at loving others. Wouldn't you say that's a correct statement? While Paul was not under the law of Christ, he willingly placed himself under the law to Christ. Do you see the difference in the wording there? When it came to his love for others. There's a difference in the two. Now let's take a few minutes to look at the positive side. What